Welcome, Animac Nation, and welcome to our National Lunch and Learn League event. My name is Carrie Fitzpatrick, and I'm here to kick things off before your instructor gives you the tools to increase your income with Facebook. Today's class is a very popular topic for us. We've had hundreds of requests from across the country from agents just like you who want to take advantage of this powerful social media resource but want more direction before boosting, targeting, and retargeting. Remember, the National Lunch and Learn League is just one small part of our larger productivity platform called Animac Works. Animac Works is free to all realtors and is sponsored by the mortgage professional who invited you here today. Animac Works offers our referral partners help with staging, for sale by owners, and farming amongst hundreds of classes from you to choose from. Before I turn it over to our instructor, I want to ask you a couple of questions though. A couple of important questions about your real estate career. First, do you mine a database? Do you proactively market yourself to at least 250 people in a database who know you as their realtor? You see, database mining is one of the most important skills you can develop if you want to prosper in today's real estate industry. My second question is, do you manage a geographic farm area, like a subdivision? Do you claim a pride of ownership in a geographic territory, in your town or your marketplace? Animac Works believes that we can help real estate agents by introducing new skills that have been proven to increase income. Keep an eye out for our Animac Works training calendar of events. Make sure you look for database mining, because database mining can add $2 million to an agent's annual production. And look for Farming Fridays too. We want to teach you how to dominate a geographic farm area on a budget. Can you imagine just two events on our Animac Works training calendar adds a possible $3 to $4 million to your production? See, that's what we're all about at Animac Works, and that's why for almost a decade, our slogan has always been that our success is truly measured by yours. Now get ready for the deep dive into the social media world of lead generation, sales funnels, and follow-up. It is my pleasure to introduce you to a 30-year veteran who has spent the last 4 years managing Facebook and LinkedIn marketing strategies for real estate lead generation. One of the founders of the Animac Works productivity platform, Mr. Russ Fitzpatrick.
Well, I want to welcome everybody to the Animac Nation and today's National Lunch and Learn League event. This event is sponsored entirely by Animac Home Mortgage, and it's brought to you by the mortgage professional that's in the room with you. We put together a comprehensive curriculum for our real estate referral partners, and then we paired that curriculum up with technology that is a patented smart lead capture technology. Most recently, we launched our PropertyWorks, Animac PropertyWorks lead generation system. And all of these systems are meant to really lock arms and partner with you, the real estate professionals in the markets that we served. We set out a couple of years ago, about 7.5 years ago, actually, to become the number one realtor referred mortgage player in every market that we enter. And we rely on the mortgage professional in that room and your relationship to deliver that promise. My name is Russ Fitzpatrick, and I'm one of the lucky founders of Animac Works, the Animac Works productivity platform. And I have noticed that there's a couple of different types of real estate agents in every market that we enter. There's the realtor that has a bug's eye view on their career, and they can only see a couple of weeks or maybe at best a couple of months in their journey. They don't play the long-term residential real estate profession in the way that other realtors do. And then there's the bird's eye view realtors that are in the room that have a 3 months, 3 quarters, or even 3 years perspective on their real estate career. They have a much longer, higher perspective on their real estate career. And I just want to confide in you, after 32 years of working in the real estate industry as an agent, I worked in the industry as a broker owner, managing 540 realtors of my own. I also worked as a franchisor, and I've been involved in this management of the Annie Mac Works productivity platform now for almost a decade. And that's given me a perspective as well on these two different types of real estate agents. Today's class is about social media. It's about the next decade. It's not about the next 2 weeks. It's not about the next 2 months. It's about the next decade and how exactly top realtors are taking advantage of hyper-local social media. It's about how realtors are approaching social media in 2018, 2019, 2020, and beyond. The perspective that I'm going to share with you is very, very similar to a bug's eye perspective on the achievement within for sale by owners, farm areas, expired listings, joining a networking environment like BNI or absentee owners, or even probate real estate. A lot of realtors will start a project like farming, and they'll have a bug's eye perspective on their farm. They won't be looking at it like an annual plan. They'll be looking at it like, what am I going to get next month from my farm area? And unfortunately, residential real estate is not a monthly business. It's not even really a quarterly business. It's semi-annual at best. And in most cases, the marketing that you do in December and January and February will pay dividends in August and September and October. And that's just the way that the residential real estate enterprise works. So it's the same for Facebook or LinkedIn as it is for your expired listing campaign. It has to be a quarterly or semi-annual observation of results. And the plan has to be annual in its interpretations, not monthly or weekly. And I just needed to make that point clear. Now, we're going to go fast today. We're going to go fast through some great opportunities that involve how to attract sellers from social media, how to attract buyers from social media, how to build your personal sphere of influence through social media, and how to create lasting, sustainable returns on investment as it relates to social media. But I'm going to use some other bird's eye or bug's eye perspectives on other opportunities that exist in residential real estate. So as an example, for a decade and a half, I made a fantastic living, more than six figures, on my expired listing campaign every year after year, for probably 14 years. And I would spend about 9 hours a week working the expired listing marketplace, usually go on about one appointment a week, roughly one appointment a week. And each year, that expired listing campaign would create about 25 listings in a calendar year. Now, those expired listings would sell about 70% of the time, maybe sometimes 80% of the time. But let's just say we averaged about 20 closings a year from expired listings. This is a fantastic opportunity for you to understand how top agents across the country take a source of business like expired listings and commit to an annual program, not a three-month trial, right? There's a big difference between trying a three-month trial and trying an annual plan or committing to an annual plan. A few months ago, Annie Mac Home Mortgage sponsored our eBowl for sale by owner CRM. The FSBO eBowl CRM program is proven, But many agents will try the for sale by owner program for a couple of months and then quit. And the reality is, if you're going to have a bug's eye perspective on for sale by owners and you're going to only work them for a couple of months, you're never going to get the fruits of your labor of that an agent that makes a huge commitment or an annual commitment to it. So again, a bird's eye perspective looks at for sale by owners as 30 prospects a month for 12 months. And those 360 prospects at the end of the year turn into about 15 listings. And those 15 listings turn into 11 closings. Well, there's a $77,000 a year annual plan that centers around an annual commitment. There are so many sources of business that exist. These just form the analogy for you to understand that when we talk about social media over the next 30 minutes, we're going to be talking about a plan that you have to decide. Do you have a bug's eye perspective? Oh my gosh, look how steep this hill is. And look how hard this is over the next 60, 90 days. Or do you have a bird's eye perspective on, oh my gosh, look at how big this opportunity is long term. So if we went after absentee owners in your market and we went after 100 absentee owners a month for 12 months, you know, we're talking about 1,200 absentee owners during the course of a year. And at the end of the year, it's 8 closings. That's not a bad play for any residential real estate agent. One more example I'd like to make relative to a bird's eye perspective versus a bug's eye perspective is the idea of networking. Maybe you join the Young Republicans Club, or maybe you start attending PTA meetings with the other parents at your school, or maybe you join a BNI chapter or some other version of networking, JCs, Kiwanis, the Chamber of Commerce, and you have a bug's eye perspective, meaning you go to a meeting and you didn't get any business. And you went to another meeting, you didn't get any business. And you've been to 3 or 4 meetings now, no business. So you say, I'm not going to keep going to those BNI meetings. There's no business in them. But other realtors average a couple referrals a month and maybe do their first closing a month. Literally, their first closing a month from that membership to the JCs or that membership to Kiwanis Club or that incredible relationship that they have with the American Legion or their Chamber of Commerce or the BNI group, whatever networking environment that you commit to for an annual plan, you will have success with. But it's when you have this kind of short-term thinking. I'm building this up because the opportunity for you exists in social media to, from today forward, have a bird's eye perspective on your social media enterprise and to look at it as one of several sources of business within the context of a larger business plan. And in each one of your sources of business, you can easily project a predictable and recurring income. So let's take Facebook, targeting and retargeting, and suggest that there are thousands and thousands and thousands of real estate agents that are proving today that you can build a business from social media lead generation. You can build a fantastic business by using a few tools to better equip yourself to participate in the opportunity that is in social media today. And I would submit to you that if you put in about 3 hours, one time per week, I'd like to think that you time block a certain 3 hours each week. Maybe it's Monday, 9 to noon, or maybe it's Saturday afternoon when you're at your open house. or it could be any day during the week that's consistent, ritualistic, and structured, that you set aside 3 hours per week to do your social media targeting and retargeting and your boosting. If we use 30 clicks a week as a benchmark or a goal, that would probably be far less than $75 per week that we have budgeted. But when you look at this $4,000-ish plan, this truly becomes an annualized perspective. So out of those 30 clicks that you're working with in each week, you end up with maybe one, what we would call solid, fully filled out form per week out of your 30 clicks. And that might be 52 leads per calendar year. You see why this bird's eye versus bug's eye perspective was important. Because when a lot of real estate agents, you know, get excited about social media, then they try for a couple of weeks or a couple of months and they go, well, we got a lot of clicks, but I didn't do any business. So I'm going to quit and I'm going to assume that social media is not for realtors. And that couldn't be farther from the truth. I know 20 realtors that are in my speed dial right now that make $300,000 and $400,000 a year, and they're building social media as a part of that business. You know, the first $90,000 a year or the first $60,000 a year comes from their social media source. So if at the end of the calendar year, 15 of the 52 leads were qualified, and you ended up with 10 closings, whether they were sellers or buyers, you know, there's not a bad way to make $70,000. If you spend a little bit of time and a little bit of intention and a little bit of focus on social media, about 3 hours a week, and you invest just a little bit of money in targeting and retargeting, you could, you know, have a very, very healthy return on investment that's predictable, probable, and likely. Now, I want to speak to the agents in the room that do not have the kind of capital to invest in their real estate career. You know, you've got to get involved in lead sharing with either a team, or you got to get involved in some sort of a lead platform if you don't have any money to invest. You've got to go out and make prospecting calls and door knocking and spend time and effort selling and prospecting every single day. Because if you don't have the kind of money to invest in your career, then there's two kinds of equity that you build in the residential real estate industry. The first one is called sweat equity, where you're out there working for the money, doing open houses, knocking on for sale by owners' doors, networking at events, and also joining some kind of a lead platform, either at your brokerage or partnering with a top listing agent where you can share leads with them. That's called sweat equity. And then today, on the left-hand side of your screen, we're showing you what check equity looks like, meaning I go ahead and buy a Mojo account. I go ahead and buy a Vulcan 7 account. I'm working with for sale owners where it's direct marketing. I'm spending a little bit of money on absentee owners every year. I spend my annual fees for B&I, and I spend some money on targeting and retargeting in Facebook. This plan that you're looking at, and I invite you to stand up with your smartphone and take a photograph of this, because this is true six-figure secrets right here. This is how elite real estate agents go from, you know, struggling under $2 million a year in production to comfortably closing $4, $5, $6, and $7 million a year. And I've actually helped hundreds of realtors grow businesses above $20 million a year using source of business charting and really understanding how you can manage different sources with a bird's eye view on your career. The first step to your social media enterprise is going to be to sign up for a Hootsuite account. There are other ways to manage your social media, but none more efficient then aggregating all of your social media under Hootsuite. So we first recommend a Hootsuite account. It just saves you time. It allows you to manage all of your posts to all of your social media from one place. It also allows you to schedule future posts so that you don't have to be sitting next to your computer all day on Facebook. So you can see on your screen right there, there's professional level relationships that you can have 10 social media accounts for $20 a month. And then there's bigger 3-user accounts if you're managing your team that are $100 a month. But I really do encourage you to open a Hootsuite account. The second thing that is pretty much mandatory if you're going to get involved in the world of social media marketing is you have to have a landing page product. You have to have some kind of a landing page product. There's ones called, the real expensive ones called Infusionsoft. There's Instant Page. There's several different vendors that play. Just type in Google landing pages or landing page template. My favorite one is Unbounce because I have an Unbounce account. And we have a premium edition Unbounce account that I manage, but you can do an essential Unbounce account for about $800 a year. And that is a necessary piece of social media marketing. You have to have what's called squeeze pages and landing pages. And these templates have been proven, whether you use Infusionsoft or Instant Page or Unbounce, to create domain names that capture the leads. So I'm going to give you an example of an ad that is proven to pull plenty of residential real estate inquiries. Stop renting now. If you pay more than $2,500 per month in rent, that's a market-specific number. In Southeast Florida, we use $3,000 per month in rent. You could be in beautiful single-family home, mortgage programs with as little as 1% down, up to $15,000 down payment assistance program, if that's available in your market. The keys to your new home are waiting, and I've watched several companies use a free 15-minute platinum pre-qualification through AnnieMac to drive traffic to their StopRentingNow.com or some other landing page. Own your own pool home. Click now. A 3-bedroom, 2-bath home with a private pool can be bought today in your city. Can be bought today in your city for under $2,000 per month. Tout the types of government financings that are out there. USDA 0% down, 1% down programs. VA no money down programs. Even down payment assistance or closing cost help. If you have first, last, and security, plus a job for at least 2 years, you may qualify. And then you drive that traffic not to an MLS search page, but specifically to an Unbounce landing page. And I'm going to show you what one looks like right here. So when the consumer clicks on your ad, they're not thrust into the MLS to search. You customize the message. If you are currently paying more than $3,000 in rent, we can help. 5 quick qualifiers. Now, could you imagine that you and your mortgage professional were fielding clicks and inquiries from people who actually filled out a form? You guys know what a registration pop-up is, right? A registration pop-up is when the consumer is searching on your IDX web page, and they see a property that they like, and then a little bubble pops up in front of them and blocks them from going any further. That's called a registration pop-up. They're very, very ineffective because the consumer simply types in Donald Duck 555-1212, and then they look like they registered. So now you have 98% of your registered guests on your website that are either false, misleading, or won't return calls anyway because they didn't really want to talk to a realtor. They were forced to register on a pop-up. These squeeze pages are different. squeeze pages or landing pages are voluntary in nature. The consumer is actually raising their hand and saying, I would like more information about this. We can tell if you qualify for purchase or rent to own in about 5 minutes based on five quick questions. So the consumer then says, hey, I want to find out about that. And they fill in that form. And I can assure you that you, me, and your mortgage professional would prefer a voluntary form filled out than a registration forced pop-up. But you need to have a call to action on your squeeze page. The reason that the word squeeze is used, because the page itself forces the consumer down a funnel. And if that consumer wants the more information, they are squeezed into filling out the form. If they don't want the information, they simply click off of it. So I can show you some 854 visitors, 447 conversions, about a 5.5% conversion rate on a variant of that ad that you see, Stop Renting Now. I will gladly pay per click on Facebook for 854 visitors that turn into 47 filled out forms. That's an ideal conversion rate. That means I spent $341 if I was paying per click, or I spent $7.26 per conversion. $7.26 per conversion. That is an exceptional voluntary raise their hand form filled out conversion price. And that's 5.5%. So again, using Hootsuite to schedule these and or Unbounce to capture the leads, we manage a lot of different variants. Sell your home for the highest price if you can close by Thanksgiving. Sellbythanksgiving.com, free evaluation. So you could say sell your home for the highest price if you can close before the start of the next school year. And that provokes a sense of interest from the consumer on social media. So it says sellbeforeschoolstarts.com. And then it goes to a squeeze page that looks like this. Do you need help selling your home? We could sell your home for the highest price if you can close by before school starts. Please fill out this form. Now, we have dozens and dozens and dozens of ad variants. Empty Nester Special, sellyourbighouse.com. Free report. Kids off to college, are you looking to downsize? This year's the perfect time to sell your big house and move to the perfect home. Maybe it's a golf course home. Maybe it's a lakefront home. Maybe it's in the mountain. All of your choices are more affordable in 2018 than they will be in 2019. Interest rates are expected to climb. Sell now and get into an affordable mortgage in your new home before the holidays. Sellyourbighouse.com. See, you create the squeeze page as the realtor, and then you share the leads with your mortgage partner to qualify them to make sure that it's financially reasonable. Save up to $12,000 on your next move, the Empty Nester program or the upgrade program. Here's a squeeze page that I learned about where they actually use a guarantee, which may or may not be useful for you, but your free market analysis will include, and then it drives them to this very specific squeeze page. You have to use landing pages. You have to use Unbounce landing pages or squeeze page templates to get people to drive their registration in your form. And again, I have to go relatively quickly here because I could really spend 8 hours with you. In no uncertain terms, if we spent one full day together, we could really start to break the surface. But during this National Lunch and Learn League, I'm going to show you some sample squeeze pages that are effective. This gentleman out at HomeSmart in California uses a free market analysis squeeze page. Santa Clarita Real Estate, Michael Bjorkman team, instant property evaluation. you see that bar on his website, it's not taking people to a website to search for properties. It's asking sellers if they would like to get a property evaluation on their home. And I'm going to use Michael Bjorkman again in a few minutes to show you how some of the best realtors in the country are getting leads from social media. So if you want to be the best in the world, you need to learn from the best in the world. You need to make it your life's work to study this sector of the industry. FrankKern.com is a guru in this marketplace. Lori Ballen at Ballen Brands is another guru. And I watch, study, listen to, pay for their coaching. I listen to everything that they're doing because you have to stay on the cutting edge of an industry like this that's changing so rapidly. And the last thing I did that I would recommend for anybody, this is a completely free learning environment on Facebook. Facebook does a series of trainings for guys like you or ladies like you that want to learn more about the industry. Now, I can't cram, 50 modules worth of training into a 1 hour or half hour lunch and learn, but I can guide you to facebook.com/blueprint. And if you will take the time to learn the blueprint process, you'll know everything that Frank Kern and Lori Ballen know. I can tell you that because Facebook invented it and they'll teach it to you for free. They won't charge you any guru fees. It's all about how to manage your campaigns, your leads, your opportunities, your sales, and your clients, and how to retain those clients through your social media. A couple of examples I'll use is all you have to do is to go to Lori Ballen Team Las Vegas, and you can see her actual ads. Now, imitation is the highest form of flattery. So if I were just starting out in real estate in 2018, and somebody said, what should I do on social media? I would just do exactly what Lori Ballen does. She's a juggernaut success story. She sells hundreds of homes every year. She's got a massive team. She sells her system called Ballen Brands to realtors all over the country. Well, why would you have to go through all that? Why don't you just copy her exact posts word for word and then make those same posts on your social media with your contact information? The world of residential real estate is a copycat business, but so few realtors actually copy the things that works. That's why realtors are starving to death. Why would Lori put a slogan in the top of her profile rather than her own picture? Maybe that's a clue. Maybe having Lori Ballen Team, your phone number, and your website is better than having a picture of yourself in the top left-hand corner of your business page. So, like I said, I just copy what she said. And notice her phone number is a prevalent part of her social media presence. So you don't have to be a genius to be effective in social media. You just have to copy the most effective people. So I really strongly recommend that you change your business page to Russ Fitzpatrick, Coral Springs, and your phone number, because that's what Lori does. Get rid of that picture of yourself and put in your slogan or your logo and the name of your team and your company, your website and your phone number, and then change the name of your business page and don't put all personal stuff in it. Make it a business page, right? But look at her post, cheap houses for sale in Las Vegas. Could you do a post that says cheap houses for sale in Miami, cheap houses for sale in Atlanta? Cheap houses for sale in Watertown. It's just copy verbatim what she does. Do the exact same thing with the exact same processes, but edit it to fit your market and your real estate business. Four tips on how to sell a tenant-occupied property. That's a very effective post that Lori Ballen did. And you don't have to listen to me. Go to her page, loriballen.com. and on Lori Ball on Facebook and search what she does. How the Las Vegas real estate market is affecting your home's value. You know, and it's got stats and a report. Now, I told you I'd go back to Team Bjorkman. A few months ago, we had Michael Hellickson, the listing champion, come on to a National Lunch and Learn League, and he shared this with you if you were at that Lunch and Learn League. But I think it's especially important during this hyper-local social media Lunch and Learn to revisit the way that Team Bjorkman writes their ads for social media and how they drive them to squeeze pages like we talked about, so that you could mimic that in your local market. And I promise you this, as a neutral third party, I'm not trying to sell you anything. If you will have a bird's eye perspective and make this an annual plan for yourself, you'll set aside about 3 hours a week. And even if you spent no money, no dollars on boosting or reboosting or targeting, you would have success and your real estate career would take off because your sphere of influence and your friends and family would see you as a more full-time, more committed residential real estate agent. So his ad says, spring is right around the corner, which grabs your attention. It says, you'll be surprised at current market trends. If you are thinking of selling, use this site to get started. You will receive a market evaluation immediately. We will then call to set up an in-home consultation as soon as we get your info. See, the most important thing about this ad for all realtors to notice is the way that he sets an expectation. We will then call to set up in-home consultations as soon as we get your info. So he's ensuring himself that the consumer is officially raising their hand and saying, pick me, I'd like you to come out to my home. Because it does you no good, and I'm going to say this with all caps and air quotes, it does you as a real estate agent no good to give away free market evaluations without going to the seller's home. So there's companies like Bold Leads, there's companies like iCloud, Zestimates. There's no value to the realtor in an online evaluation. The value to the realtor is, I want to come over to your home because I can't tell how much your home is worth if I don't see your home. I have to see what the condition is, the lot size, the upgrades that you've did. Any realtor in any of those rooms across the country that tells me that they can tell the value of a house without ever going in it doesn't know how to be a good realtor. Because the value is not giving them the value over the phone. The value is getting in their house and explaining to them how you came up with the value and how you're going to help them sell it. So the reason this ad is so important to me in the world of social media, because it sets an expectation and it asks for a decision and a call to action. So I'm really, really proud to go back to Michael Hellickson's Club Wealth coaching program and to tell you that Michael Hellickson and the Club Wealth coaching program did a lunch and learn for us. And we encourage you guys to learn from them. Because when you study these click-throughs, you study, 10,000 views and 371 clicks, you start to see that not every click turns into a form filled out. I'm going to slow down for just a second. The objective is to get the click in the first place. And then the next objective is to get the person to fill out the form in its entirety. Now, you may not be able to see the small print up in those little boxes on the left, but the purple box on the left says that 30 humans filled out the whole form in its entirety, and another 65 humans did what's called a partial lead, like they filled out a part of the form and hit send, or they filled out a part of the form and left. When you're managing squeeze pages, the first objective is to write a compelling ad that drives traffic to the squeeze page. And then the second objective is to see how many of the visitors to the squeeze page that you can get to fill out the full lead form. On the next two boxes, it looks like a rust-colored box in the middle. It's like a reddish-orange. It says that the average price of a house for the fully filled out leads was $450,000. And that the average price of a home for a partial lead was about $500,000. So Team Bjorkman, with this ad, captured 371 clicks, and 30 of those clicks, almost 8% of his clicks, filled out a full lead form at about $450,000 house value. Now, that's his market. That's the market that he works in. But this is the last point I really want to make strongly. Would it be difficult for you in Watertown, New York? Sarah Marvin Kane from Annie Mac Home Mortgage in upstate New York, or Joe Doherty from Syracuse, or Corey Parker in Waltham, Massachusetts, or any number of Annie Mac Home Mortgage professionals from across Annie Mac Nation are sitting with you as a realtor. Would it be difficult for you to mimic this ad? To basically copy this content and to post an ad. And if you posted an ad in social media regularly, and this is not a bug's eye view, this isn't a 1 week thing. This is over time, you were able to boost. Imagine, shake your head and say, I wouldn't be able to believe it that 30 sellers would contact me and ask me to list their home or to come over to my home, to their home, and visit with them about selling their house. I've been selling real estate every day since 1986, and I've used ads like this since the inception of social media, and I've studied with Frank Kern, and I've studied with Lori Ballen, and I've studied the entire Facebook Blueprint program, and I've copied people like Michael Bjorkman or Michael Hellickson, and really started to understand how their squeeze pages work. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt that my favorite headline is, we will sell your house for the highest price if you can close by February 28th, 2018. It's in bright yellow at the bottom. It says, we will sell your house for the highest price if you can close before the beginning of the school year. Any of those date-sensitive ads seem to pull really, really well. The other ads that pull well are empty nester ads, move by a certain date ads. I love those seasonal seller ads and the empty nester ads. These Facebook boosts and Facebook ads average about 40 cents per click. So it's a very, very cost-effective way, much, much less expensive than Google pay-per-click ads. And I think much, much more effective. I can only hope that you'll have a bird's eye perspective on your social media marketing program, and that you'll start to look at an annualized plan with your mortgage partner so that, you and your Annie Mac mortgage professional can qualify maybe a dozen leads a month over a 12-month period of time, rather than you looked at kind of like some people like to call it an entrepreneurial seizure, where you have like an epiphany and it lasts for like a month or two, right? It's just not very effective in residential real estate to kind of try something real hard for 90 days. You're better off committing to something so that over the next three quarters of the year, you can start to measure those results out into perpetuity. Remember, it only takes a couple of $10,000 commission checks to really pay back and create an exceptional return on investment for a particular campaign.
Well, there you have it. That's the National Lunch and Learn League event centered around hyperlocal social media and this new art form whereby realtors are able to generate commission dollars from a campaign. And I'll tell you what, teaching social media in 2018 is a daunting task. When you've got 6,000 real estate agents scattered across the country in private rooms, in different residential real estate offices, title companies, and mortgage branches across the country, you really second guess your priorities of how you're going to entertain the topic. And I want to tell you something, guys, in closing on this event. I am a 50-year-old man who has made an exceptional living in residential real estate for nearly 32 years. And I have managed hundreds and hundreds of realtors across the country who some have struggled and some have succeeded beyond their wildest expectation. And I want to end today's National Lunch and Learn League on one topic, and that is the topic of time. The feedback is so vital that we've been listening to you guys across the country. And I just need to say this. I've got a daughter at Loyola who goes to school, you know, 21 hours of credit hours in this semester. I've got a daughter at Florida State that does 15 or 18 credit hours per semester. We put a son through college already. I've got two kids left in high school. And when I graduate these kids from college, and when you graduate your children from college, or you had invested $60,000, $80,000, $150,000 into your college education, and you spent a cumulative of 150 hours of credit hours into your education, I ask you, right there in this National Lunch and Learn League, is 40 minutes of digging into social media too much time comparative to that college degree? Because when my daughter graduates Loyola, my other daughter graduates Florida State, I don't expect that they're going to earn $150,000 a year 1 year out of college. But I can guarantee you something as a friend, as a third-party neutral advisor to your real estate career. If you'll invest 10 hours on Facebook Blueprint, re-listen to this 40 minutes of National Lunch and Learn League event, and you will really integrate these best practices that Lori Ballen and Frank Kern and Facebook Blueprint teaches you, and the Bjorkman team and Michael Hellickson, and all those examples of ads that we taught you. I know with 100% certainty that you will take a six-figure income out of your social media enterprise without much trouble. Yet we'll send our kids to college for $80,000, $120,000, $150,000, have them spend hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours in teaching, training, and coaching environments. They won't make six figures their first year out. Yet you've got an opportunity right now in front of you from the National Lunch and Learn League event, building on that source of business charting that we talked about at the beginning, and adding Facebook targeting, retargeting, and squeeze pages to your real estate enterprise, that you'll make six figures this year if you'll integrate those plans. So I want to challenge you to invest the kind of time necessary to become expert at this and really become a shining star in social media in your local marketplace. You will not regret it. It's my pleasure. It's my privilege. It's an honor to work with so many real estate agents across the country. And it's because of the Annie Mac Home Mortgage Works platform that we can deliver this information for you at no cost and certainly no obligation. So show some appreciation, show some loyalty, and show some love to your mortgage professionals in that room. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. We wish you luck in your social media enterprises from here on in.
Well, thank you, Russ. What an amazing amount of information you just gave us all. I want to thank all of the members of the Annie Mac Nation for participating in our National Lunch and Learn League event today. Remember, next month, we're going to take you into the fast-moving world of dynamic, searchable MLS feeds on Facebook and teach you how you can leverage Annie Mac's PropertyWorks to place an MLS search bar on your social media. So let's get together on the first Wednesday next month to take a deep dive into this cutting-edge technology that has recently been added to our ever-changing platform. And if you would like more information on the platform as a whole, please speak to the mortgage professional who invited you here today. And as always, I'll see you next time.